Introduction to you to our West Indies.
You know where is the house of Monsieur Beaumont?
In that case,
we might have been caught.
Caught? By whom? Those men you spoke to?
They are not men, monsieur. They are dead bodies.
Dead?
Yes, monsieur. Zombies. The living dead. Corpses taken from that grave. Or made to work. Sugar mill. Come!
Excuse me. Have you got a match? Did I frighten you?
I'm sorry. I'm ugly enough, I suppose.
No, it wasn't you. Something happened back on the road there. We stopped and took some men. The driver told us they weren't men at all. He said they were crooks. Surely you don't believe it, do you?
No. Well, I don't know.
Baby is full of nonsense and superstition.
They're always mixed up with a lot of mysteries that turn your hair gray. I've been a missionary here for, 30 years. And at times, I don't know what to think. Come, let's go in the house.
Oh, yes.
Well, come with me.
Is Mr. Beaumont in?
You're expected, Dr. Bruller.
Yes, I did. I've been sent for to marry you something. Maybe we have.
How long is it that you know Mr. Beaumont?
For only a few days. Mappin introduced him on the docks in Port-au-Prince.
And you?
I met him on the ship coming from New York. He was very kind during the voyage.
Oh, Madeline and I planned to be married the moment she arrived, but Mr. Beaumont persuaded us to come here. He promised to take me out of the bank at Port-au-Prince and send me to New York as his agent.
Strange. Very strange.
I'll tell Mr. Beaumont you're here. It's all right, isn't it, Doctor?
Oh, I guess so. You see, I've
only met Mr. Beaumont once or twice. But he never struck me like a man that takes a drug to play a fairy basketball with a young couple like you. Unless
what, sir?
I suppose you think I'm a meddling old fool, but you know, I'd feel a good deal better if you'd clear out of this place after you're married and have nothing more to do with Mr. Bowman.
Young people have arrived, sir, and Dr. Bruner. They're waiting in the reception hall.
Show them to their room and tell them I'm out.
No, wait.
Perhaps I'd better see them. It might have gone if I didn't.
Very odd, sir. Especially as Dr. Bruner is a trifle skeptical as to your motive, sir.
Never mind my motive. Has that other person sent word yet?
No, sir, not yet.
Yes, yes, indeed.
Oh, yes, of course. I'm sure Neil will make a very good agent. But you must be tired after your drive. You'll get some rest. Silver. Silver will show you to your room.
This way, please.
delighted to see you again, Monsieur Beaumont.
Journey. He demanded for my milk.
Then
they work faithfully. They are not worried about wrong hours.
You could make good use of men like mine on your plantation.
No.
That's not what I want. Then perhaps you should talk about the young lady who came to your house this evening.
You've seen her?
Where? The road. Tonight.
There was a young man.
They're to be married tonight. You waited too long to do anything.
What do you want me to do?
If she were to disappear for a month,
what do you hope to gain
by her disappearance?
Everything.
Everything.
Do you think she will forget her lover in a month?
Just give me a month.
One little month.
Not in a month.
Not even a year.
I looked into her eyes. She is deep in love.
But not with you.
Been married within an hour.
There must be a way.
Give me what I want, and you may ask anything.
If I'm to help you.
Keep it, monsieur. Keep it. You may change your mind. Send me word when you use it.
I'll find another way.
There is no other way.
Thank you.
You could raise me up to paradise, or you could blast my world into nothing. There's time you bring your spirit. I can make you the angel of every woman. I'll give my own life to make you happy. Oh, listen to me, dear, before it's too late.
Don't. Please.
Don't go with her. We can be in Port of Prince in half an hour. There's a boat sailing at midnight.
You've been so wonderful.
One last gift before I lose you forever.
We are gathered together here in the sight of God and in the face of this company to join together this man, this woman, in holy matrimony. Faith.
To the bride, to beauty's queen.
Gladly, my lord.
Leave but a kiss.
Fair gentlemen,
leave my fortune.
Madam.
Zombies!
Yes. They are my servants. Do you think you can see it alone? In their lifetime, they were my enemies. I saw the rich doctor. Once my master. Secret, I talked about of him. Wangerda, the swine, fallen creature. He fought against my spells unto the last. Even yet I did struggle and fight. His Excellency Richard, once Minister of the Interior. Garcia, Brigand Chief. Marquis, Captain of Gendarmerie. This is for man. I, executioner. Almost executed me. I took them. Just as you say. This one. But what if they regain their soul? They will tear me too. And that, my friend, shall never be.
Certainly.
Explanations that strike me. Either the body was stolen by members of a death cult that used human bones for their ceremony, or else...
Or else what?
She's not dead. Not dead? Are you mad? I saw her die. The doctor signed a certificate. I saw them bury her.
Now, wait a minute. Wait a minute. I'm not... But I've lived in these islands for a good many years. And I've seen things with my eyes that make me think I was crazy. There's superstitions in Haiti that the natives brought here from Africa. Some of them can be traced back as far as ancient Egypt. And beyond that, yes, in the country that was old when Egypt was young.
Yes, but what has that to do with Madeline? I kissed her as she lay there in the coffin. And her lips were cold.
Let me explain. Now, just a minute. I'll explain.
Wherever there is a superstition,
you will find there's also a passage. Now, do you remember what your driver told you the night he took you to Beaumont's house?
Oh, about those horrible creatures you saw.
Yeah.
He said they were caught. Yeah. Taken from their grave.
Now, wait. Now, that's the superstition. Now for the passage.
The gold,
the steam, the dead corpses from the grave. I suppose to put him there in the prison.
Do you mean that Madeline was murdered so that somebody could steal her dead body?
Ah, nonsense. No. Not her dead. Not her. Her body, yes, but not her dead body.
Well, surely you don't think she's alive in the hands of natives. Oh, no. Better dead than that.
Excuse me, please. Have you got a minute?
That, do you?
Hey, there's been lots of people that's been pronounced dead that came alive again and lived for years. Now, if nature can play pranks like that, why isn't it possible to play pranks with nature?
Oh, I don't know.
Your driver believed he saw dead men walking. He didn't. What he saw was men alive and everything but this and this.
Oh, the whole thing has me confused. I just can't understand it.
I don't blame you. I don't blame you. I've been trying for years to get to the bottom of it. To separate what you call fact from fiction. The law of Haiti acknowledges the possibility of being buried alive. Here it is in the famous one. I'll read it for you. It's in French. Do you speak French?
No.
Excuse me, please. Have you got a match? Right here. Here's the one.
No, thanks. I didn't see it.
I'll translate it for you. If you could say it.
Article 1349. The use of drugs or other practices which produce lethargic coma or lifeless sleep shall be considered attempted murder.
Mm-hmm.
Attempted.
Yes, I see. Yeah.
All right. All right. If the person has been buried alive, the act should be considered murder, no matter what result
follows. Oh, my. Say, you said that you couldn't understand why he was so interested in that. Do you think he did this?
No. No, I think it's native. Native is exactly. Of course, if you want to, we can go to Beaumont's house first.
If I can get home,
can't the authorities help?
Authorities. Me and my boy.
You don't know these islands. The native authorities are afraid to mess. I'm not. I got friends, eh?
They'll tell me things down if we ever get out of it.
Because I'm a preacher. They think I'm a magician.
Before we get through with this thing, we may uncover things that even the devil knows. Oh, it's stuck.
They can't make such a bite with those eyes. I was mad. But if you'd smiled, I'd have done anything. Given you anything. I thought that beauty alone was that. But the soul is gone. I can't bear those empty, staring eyes. Oh, forgive me, Madeline, forgive me. I can't bear it any longer. I must take you back.
Back to the grave?
No. You must put the light back into her eyes and bring the laughter to her lips. She must be gay and happy.
You paint a charming picture, Cecil.
One that I'd like to see myself.
must bring her back.
I'm just right. How do you suppose those eyes will regard you when the brain is able to understand?
Better to see the hatred in them than that dreadful emptiness.
Perhaps you're right. It would be a pity to destroy such a love as love. Let's bring to the future of the cloud. That's the wine. Silver, bring wine. We have a toast to drink.
The future up here.
Only two points.
The vow
of a habit. A glass of wine.
What are you trying to do to me?
I have other plans for Mademoiselle. I'm afraid you might not agree. I have taken a fancy to you.
Yes? Silver! Silver!
The future, up here.
You!
No! Not that! Not that!
Just as old Pierre said, a cloud of vultures always hovers over the house of the living dead.
Madeline, is she there? Oh, I must go and
see. No, kneel, my boy. Please, lie down, boy. Please be strong. Let me go up and see what I can do.
Because you cut off.
Madeline.
Can you still hear me? It is unfortunate you are no longer able to speak. I should be interested to hear you describe your symptoms. The first man to know what is happening. None of the others. Yes. We understand each other better now.
I found you. You're alive. Alive.
gentleman. I yield. Oh, my darling. What have they done to you? You know me, dear. It's real. Bear. The moment you recognize me. Come on, don't let me get away.
Excuse me, please. Have you got a match?